This is the JJO Morning Show Podcast with Johnny and Dee. Listen, rate, subscribe.
Here we go. Yeah, buddy. According to a new survey, the average American expects to gain 8 pounds over the holidays this year.
Oh, boy.
That's up from 5.5 pounds last year. The survey is great this year because it will highlight just how much we've all given up. 72% of people say they're planning to enjoy the end of the year without worrying about their diet.
Right.
That's up from last year when 54% said that. That's a pretty big increase.
I consider it my God-given obligation to put 9 pounds on. If you don't like it, hey, man. Move to Canada.
66% of people say they're going to postpone being healthy.
It's almost like you feel better about screwing up, you know, if you just put it out there. It's like, look at me. Look at me now. Enjoy it now because I'm about to get fat.
Mm. Yeah, 66% of people say they're going to postpone being healthy until 2024, which is also up from last year when just 42% said they were kicking the can down the road. So, like, there's a, like 20% of the population is like, I'm just buying a lot of sweatpants.
It's the dopamine, dude. It's the pleasure we derive from a big freaking pan of sweet potatoes.
Despite giving up on this year, 68% of people are like, yeah, I'm going to stick to my healthy habits in 2024, but maybe not right away. The average person says it takes about 19 days to get back on track after a period of, quote, letting themselves go.
Small price to pay. I mean, yeah, 19 days. It's not that bad. I got a cruise coming up, so I got to.
Oh, my God.
I'm trying to. The timing's horrible because I'm in my fat period right now.
Yeah.
You know, of eating and
drinking.
The holidays, the chocolate eating, you know, the pumpkin pies at Quick Trip. I'm kind of caught.
Right.
I'm caught in a trap.
Well, we had that story, was it earlier this week or was it last week, where it was like the average American's going to have 26 cookies and 13 pieces of cake.
Look what we just ate.
Right. Right. And that's so not like us. So we had a coworker come in here. She made chocolate chip bars with Rolos in them, right?
Give me them things or I'm going to kill you.
I know. She's like, do you guys want one? Which, first of all, is two different things. There's an emotional guilt that happens when you say no, because clearly she came in here to offer those cookies and make contact with the two assholes in the building.
Oh.
She's trying to smooth it over with the dick bags.
Ah.
And which is the same reason why Stacy cooks for us.
Ah.
And she came in here, so then it's like you feel obligated to take it because you don't want to shut her down.
Right.
Right. And then it's like, oh, well, you know, yeah, it's the holiday season. There's going to be bars around. So it's like weird. I don't know. There's a weird negotiating that happens there with your brain, and it happens quickly.
You have to just, you know, the eating part is, I mean, that's a sure thing. There's no doubt. But if you can just not stop your walking or treadmill or your routine.
Right.
There really is some good balance there.
I'm
going to start going on cruises where you don't have to take your shirt off. That's my problem. I'm going to the Caribbean.
Mm-hmm.
Or Caribbean. How do you say it?
I like to mix it up.
Fine. Yes.
Surprise.
So I guess I could not go to the pool. That's going to be tough. I don't know.
Just go to the pool.
I'm hard on myself. Everybody's kind of, you know.
Yeah. Yeah, well, you say things to yourself that you would never say to another person.
I could sit there and go, well, I could be fatter and just take your shirt off.
Yeah.
Not worry about
others. I don't know. There's also...
Why am I so worried about what other fat people think of me? Because I'm not even fat.
Right. Yeah.
And I try to do better.
Yeah. 100%.
I'm going to go on an all-potato vodka diet.
Oh, wow.
Next 2 months.
I feel like...
I mean, I've been doing it all year. I might as well keep going and finish the year.
You might want to take a multivitamin with that diet. I don't know. Not a lot of color happening there.
I get 77% of my calories from vodka.
But even if you're working out,
yeah,
even if you're staying active, if we're really truly having 26 cookies, 12 slices of pie, and 13 cupcakes over the holidays.
Yeah, you're.
And plus, you think about the libations, whatever. Brandy slush. I never have sweet drinks until the end of the year.
Well, I mean, it's not what you eat on those three holidays. It's the in-between. I mean, if you can just manage your routine and your motivation, you should be fine. You know, Thanksgiving, Christmas. You make it sound like I have to eat and not work out again for 2.5 months.
No, dude. I was just going to say, like, staying active, you're still, if you're adding all these extra calories it's not going to, you're already at a baseline. Your calories in is not going to equal your calories out, even if you stay exercising, which is why it's correct. Like, if you stop exercising, it's double.
Yeah, that's what I'm talking about.
Which, and especially with it being lack of daylight, the sun setting at 4:30 p.m.
I know.
It's extra important to keep moving because you need those endorphins to help you.
You want to stay warm, eat, and watch Hallmark Channel.
Dude, that's why I do chores at the barn. It makes me get the hell out of the house and move around in the winter. I have to do it. Otherwise, it's like I'm good at talking myself out of it. You know what I mean?
Oh,
like,
sure.
But, yeah, I was like, I have to find something that is an obligation that I have to get out of the house in the winter and not just sit and be depressed. Damn wintertime.
Well, then your age is a factor. You know, things slow down. Well, yeah, I don't know. It's the best time of the year to eat. I mean, clearly.
Right.
I mean,
it wouldn't be so bad if it wasn't stretched out over a month and a half period.
Right.
You know, if we stuck to Thanksgiving and Christmas and that was it wouldn't be so bad. But it's like, you have Friendsgiving, Thanksgiving, you have your work party, your friend Christmas party, your family Christmas party, you have both sides of the family, you know what I mean? Like, so now it turns into 10 events that you have to go to.
Right.
Wow, that gets a little more, it's less manageable.
You know what would be great for me is if I got, right after Christmas, if I got like the flu, like a really bad case of the flu.
Like in the 50s, you could order a tapeworm.
Is that true?
Yeah.
Yeah. What's an illness you can get that you'd lose a lot of weight on? That's what I need to get.
I don't know, AIDS.
What Kim Kardashian get that she lost 30 pounds? She had something going on.
She was sick?
Mm-hmm. Can't remember what it was. That's what I need. I need to just get something that makes me poop a lot.
Yeah, the 50s tapeworm thing really freaked me out. Now, this says in 22, she followed Atkins' plan.
Oh.
But I can't find anything about her being sick. Anyway, good luck.
Let me see what the plan is. Hello? Hello?
Hey, there, Jerry here.
Hi, Jerry.
I want you to know I'm deep. Let me tell you, you're not fat. I'm fat, and I'm happy.
I'm fatter. There. I know you're happy. I'm happy you're happy, buddy.
I'm happy.
I think you're just.
I'm fat.
I think you're just retaining water, Jer. I really do.
That's fine. I think you shouldn't worry. Just go on your cruise. Go swimming with your shirt on if you're that subconscious and fighting in your brain like that.
Well, it's,
or you let people live rent free there.
Yeah,
you know?
Yeah.
That's right. Kick him out.
Thanks, Jer.
I love you, Jerry.
I get back to where he's right though. I still have an expectation. I'm going to look like Zac Efron again if I pull it together. And I just, man, I'm tell you what, every day that motivation just slips a little bit. It's tough.
I don't know.
A lot of work.
Yeah.
I mean, like, all work.
Well, especially, you know, it's not like being 20 anymore.
Right.
But I figure if I know I eat enough vegetables and fruit in a day, and I know I'm hydrated, and I know I'm active, then more active than probably 90% of the damn population, and I'm pretty damn strong, and I'm like, man, if I got that going for me, I'm doing okay.
Mm-hmm.
I'll have a goddamn chocolate chip cookie bar and not feel bad about it, because I know I'm going to be out lifting hay bales and burning it off, right? And also, if I die tomorrow, I'm not going to be like, I shouldn't have ate that cookie bar. You know what I mean? Mm-hmm. Like, it's just not. I went through that whole phase where you measure everything that goes in your mouth and you work out twice a day for 2 hours. And that, you know, like, it's just, it becomes your whole life. And that's not what it's about. Unless you're a professional bodybuilder.
That's exactly what I was about to say.
You know?
There's got to be that goal. I think I'm just going to stick with my routine. I'm just going to go to the gym, do an arm workout, and leave.
Yeah.
And just roll the sleeves up. And then wear a girdle. That's my plan for the holidays.
All right. You can borrow your buddies from his hernia. It's a communal girdle.
Hey, this smells funny.
You can learn a lot listening to podcasts.
And only 3 countries in the world don't use the metric system?
Or you can listen to this one.
I can't remember where I went Friday. Oh, my God.
Oh, my God. What did I do on Friday? I got to check my calendar.
If anybody saw me Friday, call.
The JJO Morning Show Podcast.
I literally have no idea where I was Friday.
Johnny and D, nowhere but JJO.
There was some hardcore excitement yesday. Where's this at? Glendale. I know.
It's over by White Folk Bay, ain't it?
Oh yeah. A real white.
Milwaukee.
So, some people stole a car and got in an accident and took off and ended up on a golf course, and the police got them from a porta potty that they were trapped in. That's the long and short of it.
The most excitement I've had this summer on a golf course is me pooping myself.
Bro.
What? Well, I was trying to give you a relatable.
When's the last time you
trying to give you a relatable
had
moment?
A physical or something? You're just like leaking over there.
Never. Shocking.
Okay, let's go to the tape.
It happened just before noon on Port Washington Road. What looks to be a white Dodge Durango speeding away from police. You can see here the Dodge crashes into oncoming traffic on Port Washington and then makes its way across the grassy median before hitting a barrier on I-43. Suspects jump out of the car and start
they
running
just
from
explode
police
out of the car
far behind. Now, this is where things get interesting. This is video taken from golfers at Lincoln Park Golf Course.
There are
on the west
3
side of the highway,
police SUVs driving on the golf course.
Nice.
And then surrounding a porta potty. It's where they find one suspect trapped after a golfer stepped in and took matters into his own hands.
And we realized that they were being chased, and that kid was in the porta potty. We tried to tell the police officer that he was, and he went off toward the other one, and I just made a brash decision to go push the porta potty down.
Dude.
Everybody's worst beer tent nightmare.
Yeah.
Right before, it's just like, I want to push a porta potty. I want to push it over so bad.
No poops, no whoops.
Could you imagine?
So he pushed. Oh, my God.
And then imagine if you push it over so it lands on its door.
Right.
Push it up from behind so it can't get out. Man, that's worse than jail, ain't it?
And then you got to like.
It's like,
Because you kind of got to mix it up to get him out of there, you know?
Pulling a tampon out of your ear.
Good times.
Dude, golfers really are heroes.
I don't think you should put a tampon in the porta potty itself. I think you got to put it in the little garbage that's in there.
Oh, a little tampon garbage container. That's good. That's a good tip.
Yeah.
Just a tip.
I don't know how we're in 2023 and I still see signs everywhere that has to remind bitches to not put their damn tampons and pads in the damn toilet.
Unruly
like,
bitches.
Dude, for real. Like just bleeding and leaving garbage everywhere. The hell's wrong with
like
you?
Like a crime scene in
Dial
there.
It in, lady. God damn. The suspects were taken into custody. So there you go.
Man, I'll bet after that speech, not one woman going forward ever leaves a tampon floating in a porta potty again. I mean, man, you scared me a little bit there.
God, it's so irritating. I'm like, who doesn't know that? Who taught you to put a pad in the toilet and flush it?
Yeah. Well, that's just kind of a courtesy move, isn't it, you ladies?
Yeah, well,
And then where do they go? Where do they go after that, the tampons?
They get stuck in the tubes.
Of a porta potty?
No, well, of a regular toilet. A porta potty, I'm pretty sure they don't, because they suck that stuff up, and same thing.
Yeah, right, right. You get the fat burg, except with tampons.
Right.
Yeah. No, that makes good sense.
Yeah.
Dial it in, ladies. You broads are out of control, dude.
Some of them are.
God, I'm glad I'm not a woman.
And some of them, listen.
So much stuff to remember.
Yeah. You would be the nastiest bitch if you were a woman. Are you kidding me? Oh, my God.
What's this bloody sock doing in
here? God.
I panicked. I didn't have a tampon. What? What?
Man, your girl voice kind of sexy, though.
Well, thank you.
You're welcome.
It'd be funny if the cop would have went up to the dude in the porta potty, tipped over, and said, "Knocked, you know, the vent pipe."
Yeah.
Hey, you almost done in there? We gotta go to the bathroom. You almost done in there.
Literally, my worst nightmare.
Dude, that is fantastic justice. I love that so much.
Well, it's like, you know, whatever. You're out at your tea time's at 10. You're almost done with your game. Here comes some asshole.
Wouldn't you keep running? I mean, at the porta potty, that it's over. You can't just keep running, dude.
Right. So one of the cops went after the other guy who clearly kept running. I don't know how you think you're going to hide in a porta potty and you got all these witnesses around you. Not to mention, it's a bunch of narcs.
Mm-hmm.
All right. The golf course be filled with narcs.
And then the other ones, they caught all of them?
Yeah.
Four of them, you said.
And then a couple of the drivers had to go be seen for non-life threatening injuries.
Mm-hmm.
But I mean, I hope, you know, you get hit like that, you can have neck issues your whole life afterwards. But whatever, that dude is going to think twice about porta potty. He's probably got PTSD.
Man, that'd be a long perp walk, wouldn't it? You ain't going to let that guy in your squad car, are you?
I don't know. Can you hose him down before you put him in there? Right? Hey,
see, pull a gun out, aim at him, and go, "If you don't jump in that pond, I am going to shoot you in the kneecap."
Because, like, as the police officer, that's a biohazard risk to you.
Oh, 100%.
Yeah.
Are you kidding me? Hey, come in. Paul's out there. God, is that funny.
I know.
He just got snit canned.
I hope they could hose him down before they had to do anything.
You think they keep I mean, how many times does that happen? I mean, I would like to see the after picture.
Oh, hell yeah, I would.
The porta potty. And the girl that was videotaping on the golf course, it would have been her follow-up if she could have walked over there, but I'm sure they yelled at him to stay away.
Probably. They probably made him all leave.
Cheater's justice, dude. Down on the porta potty.
I walked.
The mental image, just these porta potties. You know, you got guys hiding in there, looking up at buttholes, and you get trapped in one.
I'm telling you, more of the pit toilets. Ugh. I don't know. If it was just cleaned,
you know, they beat
it's the luckiest day of his life.
If they beat him with a nightstick, he'd be black and blue from the porta potty one.
Yeah. What is that blue stuff anyway? Not sure what happens with that.
Well, it's part of it's a liquid that dissolves poo. Doesn't it break down your poo? Or is
know.
It just for smell and look?
Just for looks.
Blue is raspberry.
No, it's not.
No, what is the source of the blue?
Okay, here we go. It's a really, really powerful deodorizer with disinfectant properties meant to help combat the smells that are produced in a portable restroom.
Sure, but that you have to shut the lid. That's the only way it vents. I don't know why that's so hard for people.
I don't know either. But it appears that a lot of basic things are really hard for people to do. Gosh. All right, that's JJO News. Stay fresh, cheese bags.
Hello?
Johnny,
Yo.
It'd be like having Papa Smurf in the back of your squad car, you know?
Oh, my God.
And then you're looking at his head in your rearview mirror, there's a little blue guy sitting back there. Oh, man. That would be nasty.
So nasty.
Thanks. Yeah, I don't know if you put a I never know what's in a squad car's trunk, you know, for emergencies. They're like a tarp. I know they have gloves and stuff to, you know, take dead animals off the road.
Well,
and stuff,
if it's Mark Furman's vehicle, it's OJ's shoes just sitting in there for a while.
Alrighty.
I would assume they have like a shock blanket.
Sure.
So maybe they would put the shock blanket down for him to sit on.
Yeah, or handcuff him to a tree and wait for backup.
But you got to clean him up because otherwise you're having how many people?
How old were these people?
Oh, they were young.
How the F are you? How do you hit rock bottom in a porta potty at 20 years old?
He's going to wear it like a friggin' Girl Scout badge, dude. You know the hood's going to give him an amazing nickname.
Oh. Oh, good.
Yeah.
We do need a nickname for him.
Oh, yeah, dude. Let me call him like Lil Blue or something.
Baby Blue.
Replay today the JJO Morning Show podcast. Get up with Johnny and D. JJO.
Oh,
is that John Denver? He sounds like a girl.
No, it's Peter Paul and Mary.
Oh, I thought John Denver did that. Oh, God.
Well, I think he redid it.
Hey.
Hey.
Hey. Good for you. Hey.
What's that?
I don't know.
Oh, my God. Yeah. Okay.
I'm trying to focus over here. Sorry. I'm having a problem.
Okay.
All right.
So a plane that departed at JFK International Airport had to return shortly after takeoff.
Oh, yeah.
Horse was loose.
So I've never heard of such a thing.
Yeah. It's weird because I've looked at how they transport the animals. Someone must not have locked.
Was it in coach or first class?
Cargo. The Boeing 747 was barely at 31,000 feet when a pilot told air traffic control that a horse had escaped from its stall and was probably losing its effing mind.
Who's this, Jeff Bezos flying his prize effing horse in a plane?
Oh, no, it happens all the time. We import horses from Ireland.
Yeah, I know, but aren't they like rich people? Flying their horses.
Our farm has imported horses from Ireland.
How much is that? Let me guess. That's got to be, is that like 20 grand?
So we did two, and I want to say it was around, it was like, I think 15, and then the quarantine hold was 5.
Wow. Oh, yeah, they got it. Yeah.
Yeah.
You got to check them out.
Mm-hmm.
Got to swab them.
And a lot of people, exporting is the thing. Don't export out of here. People are importing horses in from Europe.
I guess my point would be, as far as cost would be, you'd have to go to a very specific airport where the giant airplane would be that hauls animals.
Yeah.
Giant animals.
Yeah. It's wild, all the stuff that's happening there that we never think about.
So, you know? So when Sarah Jessica Parker got loose, was she okay?
He requested a vet, actually, so I don't know.
Oh, wow.
I would drug my horse to high heaven if I was flying that sucking thing.
You would.
Yeah.
Knock it out a little bit. I guess very weird. Wouldn't you have to put a support, like a belly strap under it or like a...
It's like a big...
You want to brace it. I mean, it's like when you're hauling a horse in a horse trailer. You want it to be very... tight and confined, don't you? But with like a girth strap.
Right.
Well, I put that girth strap on you when we were on the bus to Chippewa Falls?
Yep.
You were drunk and we had to strap you down.
Yeah. And then I strapped it on later. No. Sometimes I just need to shut up. Do you ever feel that way?
Yeah.
I've watched a few different ways that they fly horses, but so the most common one, it's like a, I would say, I don't know, what is that, 5 feet tall, kind of like a giant box,
right,
without a top on it,
right,
and the horse will be standing in there like, der, 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 and they'll like be taking a little ramp up into the plane, and right, the, you know, they're just chewing their grain and having a good old time. And then it's just like a stable in there.
Yeah.
They just have the boxes all together and whatever. And then there's usually somebody that's back there to make sure there's not chaos. But apparently there's been staff cuts because this one got out. I have the call, PC2.
Oh, okay. I haven't heard this.
I would love video, but we ain't got it.
Yes, sir. We are a cargo plane. We have live animal horse on board the airplane, and the horse managed to escape his stall. We don't have a problem as of flying-wise, but we need to return back to New York. We cannot get the horse back secure.
Yeah, probably because it's an asshole. It was probably running around being an asshole and nobody could catch it.
What if the plane smells like a barn?
Probably a little bit.
Probably other animals on there if that's all they fly.
Right, you would think so.
Like a polo team would fly somewhere. They haul their horses somewhere.
Yeah, 100%. Oh, like God. I watched the video of the Olympic dressage team loading up their horses. Like, oh my God, you know how much freaking money that is? It's insanity.
You'd have to change the movie line.
Snakes on a plane.
Your mother effing horse on a mother effing plane.
Some days I'd be yelling that and I ain't even on a plane. Anyway.
Do they call it Air Horse One? Or is it just called a... Thank you.
Oh, man. The plane was headed to Belgium. It took off 6 hours later. Successfully made it at that time. But they did request a vet. The horse was, quote, in difficulty.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It's probably rolling around... Am I getting its head on crap?
100%.
What the?
And, yeah, oof. They had to dump a bunch of fuel, too.
Really?
Yeah, which I find interesting. I didn't know this was a thing.
Well, it'd be great if I could get on an airplane with an emotional support horse.
Yeah.
He's just standing there.
I would love to do a flight just watching how they...
Yeah, that would be cool.
...haul them around.
Yeah, like a Dirty Jobs episode. Or yeah.
So they were forced to make a U-turn off the coast of Boston and dump 20 tons of fuel over the Atlantic. One horse.
Some fish having a bad day.
Totally. There's
a couple of jellyfish out there having
you can thank that four-legged asshole, all right?
Hey, what's that taste? Is that jet fuel? Man, it's jellyfish out there getting a little drunk on jet fuel. Unbelievable.
Yeah.
How much money in fuel is that?
Right?
How much?
They had to drop...
Isn't that stuff
20
like
20 tons?
Isn't that crap like
it just took
bucks,
off?
Isn't that stuff like $8 a gallon or something? That jet fuel?
How much is a ton of jet fuel?
A ton of jet fuel, I'll bet, is bonkers. $10,000. No, not that.
No. So, is that really it?
You got a freaking stampede on the back of your airplane.
So. Jet fuel per metric ton, $697.
Okay. It's not horrible. Well, how many tons is that? So 20, seven. So, holy
That's
crap.
It's going to be more than that.
You're like 10 grand in fuel they just dropped.
I know, dude. Right. Yeah. Welcome to owning a horse.
Holy cow. And then.
For the best and worst times.
Get out of here.
What did dumping the fuel do?
I assume because they had just took off. I bet you can't land with that much fuel on board. You probably can't control the plane as well.
Well, that's kind of scary.
With 20 tons of fuel.
I didn't really want to know that. What if you can't dump the fuel?
Good luck, asshole.
Well,
should have had that chocolate chip cookie bar, huh?
Ah, that's why I drink. Heavily at Chili's before I fly.
Yeah.
No, so the horse, I don't know, if it was acting crazy, I wonder if they could even get a hold of it.
They said they couldn't secure
it. You just stand there and watch and hope it doesn't hurt itself.
Yep.
Good God. That is so weird.
They're so awesome, but such a huge pain in the ass sometimes.
Well, we put them in the pain in the ass situation.
Oh, 100%.
What are you kidding me?
Yeah, I know.
You'd sit there with a trank gun, like having some gorillas or something on your airplane.
Well, and
you know,
like,
that like Jurassic Park when they hit it with the stun gun.
Yeah. Well, like you look at what they look like when the dentist takes care of them and they drug them.
How do you like that pilot comes on and he goes, hey, Air Malaysia, is there a cowboy on board? We need you to get your lasso and head back to cargo.
Yeah.
We'll bump you up to first class.
No kidding.
No, there's no people on board, right?
I don't know. You'd think there'd be somebody supervising the animals so a horse doesn't get in the cockpit.
It's like Noah's Ark. You got parrots and lizards and horses and
drugs.
Gorilla. Wait, what?
Yeah, I don't know. That's wild.
That is insane.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
You have birds flying around the airplane.
I want to know whose horse it was.
I don't know why I never thought about horses being on airplanes.
Yeah.
All the time. Huh?
All the time, yeah, man. Yeah, especially, and I don't know so much, like the Western world seems to be doing quarter horses, which seem to be American kind of based.
Mm-hmm.
But like all them hunter jumper people be importing warm bloods from wherever. Warm bloods, Tricaners, all those.
You think there'd be like a rule that you can't dump jet fuel? You know, just
willy nilly
anywhere.
Yeah, they're like, here, go buy Martha's Vineyard and do it. Let the rich people smell this for a change. Dicks.
Trying to think, Martha's Vineyard. It would be up there, Barbara Streisand. Sitting out there. What's that smell?
It's getting sprayed.
And then a horse swims up and bites her on the bites her on the ankle because the plane went down.
What a day!
Poor horse. I feel bad for the horse.
I know. You would think they would be drugged. I'm just stunned he wasn't drugged.
Right?
Because they're so nervous. You would want to.
You'd think if the plane, there'd be an equivalent of an air marshal / veterinarian with a gun.
Yeah.
In worst case scenario, you'd have to shoot the damn thing.
Yeah.
Before it killed you and took the plane down. I don't know if a horse running around could take a plane down. You'd think it'd be caged up pretty good.
I wouldn't put anything past them animals.
We have a loose horse on board. Everybody stay in your seats. That is so weird.
Yeah.
The pilot's like full of puns. Hold your horses, everybody. We gotta lose some fuel here.
Oh, no.
We got an animal back there stirring up trouble. Everybody hang on to your ass. This one's going to get close.
Yeah. All right. I'll save the Wedding Crashers story for next time.
It's weird. It's kind of like a cool story, but the most terrifying thing you could ever witness.
Yeah.
Is a horse just insane running around an airplane.
Yeah, I don't know. I'm dying to know the story of why the horse is on the plane.
I'd like to see video of it.
100% would like to see video. But it is kind of fascinating. Like, if you get bored today, just Google how they fly random animals around. And, it's pretty cool.
Now I know why they move fat people around the airplane for weight distribution. I didn't know it had that much an effect, but a horse on a 747?
Yeah.
Could throw off your center of gravity? Are you serious?
Well, I don't know about that. I mean, I think the weight of the jet fuel was more the concern about the landing. I don't think they were worried about the weight distribution so much. I mean,
hey,
it's a 1,500-pound animal. I don't know.
See, we're like half informed because we both owned horses. We just don't know dick about
flying
aeronautics.
We got half the story. Which, according to Cole and Paul, is all you need.
JJO News, where you get JJO News, where you get half the facts.
Dumbing down your smartphone, one podcast at a time. Listen, rate, and subscribe to the JJO Morning Show podcast. Get up with Johnny and D. JJO.
Play the motorboat? You motorboat, son of a bitch. You old sailor, you.
Well, if I had a nickel for every time I danced to that tune, I'd be rich.
Oh, nothing like a little self-deprecation. Okay, so a 57-year-old broad named Sandra Henson just pleaded guilty to larceny, trespassing, and disturbing the peace. She crashed a wedding in September and stole from people. But it wasn't her first rodeo by any means. It was at least her second or third. She's been walking into strangers' wedding receptions for at least 6 years in at least three different states. Wow. Alabama, Tennessee, and Mississippi. And she steals not only from the bride and groom, but from the guests as well.
Oh, my God.
So what she does is she waits until everybody's all watching a memorable moment. And she's going through people's purses and taking stuff off the gift table. I mean, the balls.
Wow. It's like the movie was based on a real story.
Dude, I just don't. I suppose you just got to look confident in what you're doing. And if probably just assumes you're going through your own purse.
She learned the ways of Chaz very, very well.
Yeah. Ah! Oh, dude. I'll get you.
I haven't heard it in a while.
It has been a while.
I miss it. So it's a real thing almost.
Right.
Crash those funerals, man. Ooh, chicks are crazy horny, dude.
They're at funerals?
Oh, yeah.
You think they're more horny at funerals or at weddings?
Well, according to the movie,
funerals,
everybody was ready to get laid.
You hungry? Hey, Ma! Can we get some meatloaf? The meatloaf! We want it now! The meatloaf! Ma, the meatloaf!
Perfect. I mean, damn near perfect.
Yeah.
You know, why? How does that not, when you give out Academy Awards, why is it the movies that have the most memorable lines and moments never get recognition? And I, you know, except for, let me see what I got here.
Sorry, Wedding Crasher. She looks like, everybody's got an auntie looks like that.
Absolutely. She could get away with it.
She blends.
Yeah. And she would wait for when? I mean, whenever at the party?
People were going to, you know, catch the bouquet or they're out on the dance floor.
Run and grab a purse.
Uh-huh.
Wow.
It's kind of brilliant. Until she got caught.
I was trying to think, my wedding was small, but.
Yeah, I know. I didn't get invited.
How would you not know? Well, it was COVID, dude. What? Stand outside the church. And I'll give you the all clear.
It's fine, dude.
We'll take turns.
It's whatever you have to say to make yourself feel better about completely blowing off the person you've worked with for 15 years.
Yeah.
It's fine.
Well, I knew you weren't going to bring me a good gift, so I'm like, yeah, F it.
I mean, like that bitch can't even afford to go.
She's going to wear something from the barn into my wedding. It's like, yeah, no. We just cancel her.
I wear my good flannel.
I know you would have, and I appreciate it. It's a thought that counts.
It really is.
So trying to think, God, wouldn't you know, would you literally, you could say you were there with somebody. I'm just, you know, in a real life wedding crasher situation.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, you would need a good story, but I still think it would be pretty easy to check up on.
I mean, the scam relies upon the fact that people bring other people to a wedding that the bride and groom do not know.
Right, right.
So if they see a random person they don't know, they're so busy that day, I doubt they even connect that person wasn't with somebody.
Right.
You know what I'm saying?
It's like we're from New Hampshire, we're venture capitalists. I mean, that's going to get more attention than not, isn't it?
I don't know.
You know?
Yeah, and then
we're an emerging maple syrup conglomerate. Oh, okay.
And depending on where the gift table is at, because she was taking off the gift table.
Right.
I mean, if you wait till there's a lull in the people, you could walk around with a gift and people would think you were taking it to the table, not away from the table. Unless she was just grabbing cards, which is the way to go, because then you get gift cards and money.
Essential oils. Satin sheets, Egyptian, 300 count. Yeah. Fine crystal. I always liked that scene when they were at the table.
Mm-hmm,
He was the wedding gift psychic. I thought that was actually a good scene. There is nothing about that movie I don't like.
So John said he crashed one wedding reception as a kid. He turned out he knew the groom's mom. Damn it. There's no crashing happening there.
Oh, boy.
Yeah.
Yeah, boy, that's a ballsy maneuver, though.
She did it for 6 years.
That's incredible.
She was clearly pretty good at it.
That's blending and acting. No, you know, don't panic. You got to be believable but forgettable at the same time.
You have to blend.
You totally blend, dude.
That's why I'd be a terrible criminal.
I'd have to come at you and I say, "Oh, hi, how are you? Blah blah blah. Listen, I got to go over here and talk to."
You always explain too much.
Yeah. I'm over talking it.
Yeah.
How are you? I haven't seen you in so long. More generic.
I wouldn't even talk to him.
Oh my gosh. Where's that lovely bride at? I haven't seen her since she was just this high.
Too much, dude.
Yeah, too much.
You're busted.
You need to
go up. You need to grab a cupcake.
Yep.
Hang out. Maybe chill in the bathroom for a bit. I don't know.
You think you'd look more legit if you had you were a couple than just
right.
a loner.
Yeah.
Or even had a kid with you. Yeah, I don't know. That's a tough one to pull off.
Beware of the normies. She looks like...
They have to be big weddings.
It's got to be.
Got to be big weddings or it doesn't work.
Yep.
You got to blend. You got to steal, blend, and disappear.
Man, at this point, she could probably be like a wedding planner. You know, you crash all them weddings for that long and be like, all right, you need to go with the turkey.
But it's like, isn't it like being a porch pirate? You never know what you're going to get.
If you take the envelopes from the card box.
Oh sure, that's where the payday is.
Yeah,
you just make a run for it.
Because how many? Whatever. I mean, I suppose you could lift up the boxes to see how heavy they are. Yeah. But how many sets of, you know, flatware do you need?
Right, that's the story.
Mm-hmm.
Boy,
okay.
What a crazy.
Dude, it is a wild time to be alive.
You start believing in people again.
The JJO Morning Show Podcast with Johnny and Dee. Listen, rate, subscribe. Catch a new show every Monday through Friday, 6 till 10 a.m. on 94.1 JJO or streaming anywhere in the JJO app. Johnny and Dee, nowhere but JJO.